you feed well, you healthy food, you'll be healthy. That's why we cook for them the same way that we cook for ourselves.
It's weird actually to believe that in Europe they don't have a proper diet for their dogs, because our understanding is that Europeans have this great, you know, relationship with dogs, and they take care of the pets, you know, health-wise in terms of food and so on. So how could we find such a problem in their dogs?
They depend on canned foods.
Oh, canned food. Oh.
They depend on something ready, being cooked. For, what type of meat and other stuff in it, nobody knows.
Okay.
But whatever we cook, we know what we did cook. Chicken, beef, we know. But if you buy something ready, what is it? And what chemical they put in, what other flavor they put in, we don't know. We have also pollen water from the palm tree, malakah.
Yeah.
And this is good for the digesting. That's why we need to look after them also. And for us, both ways.
It's again something classic, okay? Now, if I didn't know about the Salugis, I would still think that this is only for humans. But obviously we can use them for Salukis as well. It's just classic.
Because as I mentioned to you, yeah, they share our tent, food, our place, our life, and our food.
And it has a very special
smell. Yeah.
Can you smell that? It smells really strong.
What is this?
This is henna.
Henna? Henna. Don't tell me you're giving them tattoos as well.
No. Henna, you know, summertime. And we use to keep for ourselves on our feet.
Absolutely.
And hands
to keep
the body temperature balanced.
Wow.
And on the head.
True.
As a human being.
True.
But for the Salukis, we keep them on their feet because they used to be on the sand all the time when summertime.
Plastic. So basically we have this henna, we put it on our own palms just to keep us cool, and now we're actually using it on the palms of the dogs.
We are proud of them. That's why we like to give them more things that we deserve.
You're not spoiling them a lot, are you?
No, not spoiling.
Not spoiling.
It's us. If you spoil your Salukis, you're spoiling yourself.
There you go. And is this honey?
Yeah, this two types of honey. Honey from flowers and honey from dates.
I don't even get any one of them. They're so lucky, those Salukis.
Are you eating healthy?
I guess I have to come to this kitchen.
You have to come?
Well, anyway, this one's really, really great, just to make sure that, you know, we do take care of our own Salukis. And start to see something more exciting.
Yes, I will show you the training area.
Training area.
And the
swimming pool. That's the whole real deal of
yes,
how they
yes,
actually get
practice.
Yes,
swimming pool and how we train them.
Let's go and see. That would be awesome.
This is the training area, indoor training. مثل ما تشوف ميدان مصغر، تعليم السباحة وتعليم الأجلبة اللي هو الصعود النزول والأرانب. راح أفرجيك الحين شيء. Show you about swimming. تعال متين أزهرك تعال.
So this is basically going to. They're gonna practice.
أي بس. أي بس هو صبر.
Swimming. Man, it's just amazing looking at them. هذا بالضبط شو اللي يفيدهم؟
ترطيب ونفس الوقت العضلات، لان احنا تمول فتره طويله داخل، بس هنا كشو مجرد 10 دقائق 5 دقائق، بس نورمالي اتس هاف ان اور. And then we leave them، يعني to leave them to 2 meter deep.
Feel like I need a shower. It's hot.
اي والله my people they have shorts they go inside also with them. يلا ودي هناك.
Good job. What's the names?
هذا وراد.
وراد.
وراد هذاك لحاق.
Dog actually putting his feet.
Salukis.
There.
Salukis again. Salukis.
Salukis.
Salukis. Salukis.
That Salukis simply put his two palms inside this bowl of water.
Yeah.
And you said something interesting. You said that they would not.
They will not. They were cooling down, but they will not drink from
they
it.
They will not drink back from the same.
Same day.
That's
yeah.
Really, really interesting.
And as you can see, this is a pot, clay pot.
Clay pot.
And
which
it's good.
It's gonna help it to keep it cold.
You can touch it. You can touch it. Cold?
It is cold.
Yeah.
is here now.
So.
She's all cleaned up. She's the only one who is allowed to sit here or not.
Get here. بس تعال يا ستة.
الله. محمد tell me about this thing that we actually have around the neck of the dogs.
This is the collar.
Yeah, the collar is really interesting. Everything is so authentic in here.
This collar actually it's part of the bishop, the veil, the men when they wear it. And as you can see, this is our bishop. And this is the veil. This is the old one. And when this expired and damaged, we don't throw it out. We use the golden part of it.
All right. So Sogha. Ya Sogha ya halwa. Ya Sogha ya harusa. فنانة حق صوغة بعد اشتباك
بس زين والله زين صح لسان
ما معرسة صوغة
هو جايب عيال من زمان بس الحين خلاص الحين تدري فترة الحين
كبر كبر برايفت
برايفت
تو فيو
نعم نعم
How would you advise people first if they think of buying a dog like a Saluki?
First of all, to go for a Saluki, it's not anyone can go for it because it needs a lot of exercise, it needs space, it needs a place to run. I mean, of course, if a person who cannot, he don't exercise, he don't go out, he don't go for dessert, he has nothing to do with wildlife, he don't do with any environment thing, why have to have Saluki?
Basically, if you're not into dogs, please don't come close.
Yeah, but if you are into a Saluki as a desert breeze, you can say, and you need to go out, you need to go hunting, you need to do a lot of activities with it, yes, you can have this type of Arabian hound. And valuable, I mean, they are very valuable to us. The price is priceless. I mean, you cannot say this much cost this much because they are not in the showcase or on the shops that you can have standard prices. But sometimes people exchange, sometimes people gift it, and sometimes there is people, they have extra puppies, they said, okay, we want to find a home for them. Even if they want to sell it for you, but they have to find a home, somebody who can look after them. Otherwise, they will not. They prefer to keep it with them. You know, running with the wind.
Absolutely. خبرني عن طلعات تظهر مع شيوخ تظهر مع رحلات خاصة مع في القنص يعني شو الأكثر شيء اللي تميزها الرحلات هذه شو الأشياء اللي تحب أكثر شيء تشوف يعني تعيشها في القنص طبعا مع السلك
نعم طول عمر مقناص تطلع مع ربعك مع أخوياك مع الشباب فترة أسبوع أو خمسة أيام مثل باكستان مثلا أو المغرب أو السودان السعودية ساعات المناطق اللي مسموح فيها القنص تونس قنص الطير قنص السلق القنص الدائم اللي هو المستديم ان انت تقنص حق هدف انك انت تاكل منه مو بتقنص علشان تقعد في رفعت رقم قياسي او شيء لا هي عملية وساعة سد وبعدين مخاواة ربعك خلاص تنسى المدينة وتنسى المشاكل وتنسى الأشياء اللي أنت تعيقه الواحد يرفح نفسه ونفس الوقت يندمج إلى شوية حياة ثانية طبع ثاني بيئة ثانية البيئة الأساسية any dog you can train him to hunt for you it's a lot
so it's back to the whole purpose thing so you don't only have to have a Saluki but any dog that is actually trained to go for hunting and to capture your food and at the same time in a way it's guarding you and taking care of your own place and your house or your tribe and so on that's something that is okay so how fast they could go like their speed
the speed they go for 65 to 70-75 kilometers per hour well trained exercise well muscular build the body I mean if I have a chance maybe next time I can show you how to chase a rabbit but not chasing on one line maneuver this is the way of the flexible of Saluki pure Saluki
absolutely
the mixed Saluki or the mixed breed Saluki they cannot maneuver
So this is actually one of the ways that you can tell if this is a pure blood Saluki or not. If they just cannot maneuver between right and left.
Yeah, you can see their back is different
shape. They don't have that curve. Yeah,
and then they should be in the normal size, not some massive high.
Well, it can't get better than this. I'm actually here in between three generations of Salugis, Soga, the older generation, and the mid generation.